empty hands held high. Such small sacrifice, if not joined with my life. I sing in vain tonight. May the words I say and the things I do make my life song sing, bring a smile to you. Let my life song sing to you.
I'm Bishop George Lucas of the Diocese of Springfield in Illinois, and I'm very happy to share the good news of a new Catholic high school to be developed in Madison County, Father McGivney Catholic High School.
And you know, and for years people had said there should be a school here in this area. But for whatever reason, it never happened. It never got started. And we said to ourselves, you know, why not us? Why don't we be the impetus for this?
What's unique about this is that a group of lay people, parents, effectively, have seen a need and really a desire to provide this for their own children and then for the children of other families in the community.
So one of the first things we did when we started was we wrote a letter and visited the bishop. We said, Bishop, we need this school, make it happen. And he said, well, a couple things here. Number one, I think it's a great idea. Number two, I don't have a magic bag of money to pay for these things. And number three, schools like these are much more successful when the impetus for it comes from the folks in the community.
And certainly we wouldn't be where we are today if it weren't for so many people showing their support. I mean, at first it was on a survey saying, yeah, we also want to send our kids to Catholic high school. But pretty soon it was folks who said, we don't just want to see this happen, we want to be part of it.
The community should be excited about the school because it does take a village to raise a child. We are trying to raise children who are going to be part of the community, and we cannot do that in isolation.
Well, you know, here's an opportunity to come together on a cause that is going to give these kids a gift, probably the greatest gift that we could ever give them, the gift of Catholic education. Father Michael McGivney is the perfect patron for this school.
We saw him as a wonderful role model of service, service to family, service to youth.
In fact, that's what Father McGivney represents. You know, nothing was more important to him than Catholic parish families.
I mean, there's been American saints before, but this is the first parish priest.
It's an opportunity, too, to recognize the good work that the Knights of Columbus, who were founded by Father McGivney, that they do in our diocese and really in so many communities all across our country.
So we couldn't be more pleased with that choice, and we couldn't be more pleased to honor the parish priests in our life and to honor the Knights of Columbus, who all collectively have given so much back to the faith.
I think it's a great motto, and I think it's a strong statement to help lead you know, the younger generations in terms of what is the purpose of life and kind of what is your purpose in being put on this earth, and how can we best display our Christianity. And
I want to learn more about Catholic faith. I want to go through more of my journey with God.
You know, we want to shape them even further into their adulthood, that every decision that they make, Christ should be at the center of that, you know, decision.
We hope that in bridging those two together, the best of our American democracy, the best of our Catholic faith, and bringing those two together, we are serving humanity, serving our brothers and sisters, serving our neighbors, serving the culture of life and helping to build up the culture of life.
School motto, your school principles of charity, unity, and fraternity are the same ones that we have, charity, unity, and fraternity. And I think there's a lot of things we can do to blend into that.
So I think because the school's named for Father McGivney, who founded the Knights of Columbus, that forms a great framework on which to develop the mission of the school.
It so comfortably coincides with high school, with the four pillars and the 4 years of high school. There's so many ways you can go with that.
Well, we live in Troy, Illinois, and we are excited to have the new Catholic high school coming to our area, because prior to that we didn't really have a lot of options that didn't require us to drive a long way.
Yeah, that would be nice to just not have something so far away.
Oh, I think it's a great idea. Unfortunately, it wasn't in place when my kids were going through the system, so I really see a need for it.
We've researched every single Catholic high school started in the United States since the year 2000. And a lot of those high schools are proud to say that they've helped with retaining students in the grade schools, especially in the upper grades, where there was not a Catholic high school option before. Once there was, those kids stayed K through 8.
Whenever I graduated 8th grade, I wished that there was a Catholic high school for me to go to, like St. Boniface Catholic High School.
I'll be in Catholic grade school until 8th grade, and I don't want to have to leave Catholic behind because I have to go to a public high school.
My family, we've all gone to a Catholic high school, all of the girls in my family, so I'm just going to try to continue that tradition.
It's going to be Catholic, and I'm so excited.
To know that they could have a 12-year Catholic education as a foundation for their lives and a foundation for the moral compass that they want to establish for their children. So especially the young families are very excited.
To get ahead, you have to have a good education. But the first thing is you have to be first with God. God has to be first with you. And the only way you're going to get it today is having a Catholic education.
The curriculum at Father McGivney High School will be designed to meet the needs of students of all abilities, including a remedial track up through honors programs. We plan to be fully accredited by the Illinois State Board of Education, the Diocese of Springfield, and the Regional Office of Education. A wide range of athletic and extracurricular activities are being planned for the opening of school in 2011. We're placing special emphasis on a curriculum that will enable our graduates to become tomorrow's Catholic leaders in the faith, community, country, and the world.
Catholic schools usually have less people, so there's more like time that you can have talking with the teacher if you have trouble with a subject.
I think a bunch of the classes will be really fun, like taking foreign languages.
Yeah, swim team, maybe tennis. I know a lot of people like that.
I want to see maybe soccer, cheerleading.
I like to learn about Jesus, and I like to learn math.
Me too.
Drama, theater, and volleyball.
Science, PE, basketball, football.
I like recess and PE.
Phonics, and pretty much like Jesus and stuff.
Well, we're looking at a June of 2011 to complete the construction. And currently we're going through the master planning and the programming phase.
You know, so we didn't get into this to build a private school. We want to build a Catholic school. And central to that, we think, is a chapel. Front and center in the school as you come into it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, from the very beginning, we talked to the architects about making sure that the chapel was a visible part of the school.
The chapel is going to be designed interior and exterior uniquely. And how we integrate those elements in the design is really going to make it look special.
Love the fact that the chapel is front and center. It's what Catholic education is all about and what a parochial education for us is all about. It pulls kids together and it tells them this is the reason why you are here.
Well, the site is rather unique. It's 80 acres, so it's plenty of land. So we have plenty of room to expand. Initially, we're going to design for 400 students, and then we're going to design in our master planning to be capable to handle 600 students and even beyond that.
I can't wait for the day that this school opens. They're not going to be able to keep me out of there. I can't wait to go through the front doors and see the students, but to really feel what I think this school is going to feel like.
If people are interested in this project and they're passive about it, they're just sitting back, just waiting for it to open, wondering what it'll be like, deciding then if they're going to do it, we're not going to be successful. We need people to jump in, to get passionate, to shape this school, to make it their own. And as that's happening, and it's happening every day right now, that's the biggest key to our success.
We all have a very great responsibility to support the high school. We have a great responsibility to support our faith, to support our parishes, to support our high school.
To support young people in any venture is quite a gift to those young people who may not realize it at the time, but the gift will come back to the community 100-fold.
People ask us, what do we need? We need prayers. hands down, we need prayers. But we need help. And we need to appeal to people. And we need folks to say, you know what? This is worthwhile of our time. This is worthwhile of our money. This is a worthwhile thing to get involved in. And for us, can think of little else that could provide the reward that this can, not just for our kids, not just for everybody else's kids, but for the community as a whole. And if people answer the call, this isn't just going to be a school. This is going to be a very, very special school and something that we will be immensely proud of in our lives.
Definitely. This is the chance that we have to really make a difference in the lives of families and in our Catholic community. It's a sacrifice for everybody who sends their kids to Catholic school. Tuition is a sacrifice, and building the school is going to be a sacrifice, and it already has been for so many people who have been so generous. But that's what we're counting on to get us forward to open in 2011.
I invite you to join me in supporting this wonderful new educational apostolate for the young people of our area. We're so grateful to Almighty God for the gift of our Catholic faith, and we realize that this gift has been given to us so that we might share it with our brothers and sisters. It's a particular responsibility to share the light of our Catholic faith with the young people of our parishes and of our families. It's a responsibility that we take very seriously, and we rely on the help of the Holy Spirit. I believe that the Holy Spirit is guiding this project, and I invite your support. Please pray with me for the success of the campaign to build and to open Father McGivney Catholic High School, and I ask you in faith to be as generous as you possibly can be.
My name is Stephanie Gatine, and I would be in the first graduating class of 2014.
My name is Jared Cody, and I'm going to be in the class of 2019.
I'll be in the class of 2015.
I'm Gabrielle Surya, and I'd be in the class of 2015.
I'm Ingrid Lovesky. I'm going to be in the class of 2023.
I'll be in the class of 2015.
I'm Allison Paige Sapkin. I'm the Father McGivney High School class of 2016.
I'm going to be in the class of 2015.
My name is Kurt Brosny, and I'll be in the class of 2020.
My name is Jennifer Gaetan, and I'm the class of 2016.
I'm Kinga Lazowski, and I'm going to be in the class of 2019.
I'm going to be in the class of 2020.